Hey everybody, Mr. Dustin here. Welcome to Bible class. Now, we're going to sing a song many of you probably already know, but there's probably some of you that you maybe don't know this song. So I need to teach you three things. Maybe you can do this with me, and you're probably going to want to stand up to do this song. So you need to know this. Wrapped up, my hands on my shoulders, wrapped up, tied up. I put my arms straight out and reach backwards, tied up. And then I'm gonna keep my hands together, tangled up, right? So I'm wrapped up, I'm tied up, and I'm tangled up. So the song is wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in Jesus. So we're gonna stand up and we're gonna sing that song together. So here we go. Wrapped up, tied up, tangled up. Got it? I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in Jesus. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in God. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in Jesus. I'm all wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in God. Oh yeah. Let's try it a little faster. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in Jesus. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in God. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in Jesus. I'm all wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in God. Oh yeah. I always like singing that song. Okay. So I hope you had fun singing that song with me. I always like singing that song. It's kind of fun because I get to get up and I move around a little bit and I would get my wiggles out. Now, today, we're going to talk about a story that I would say the people in the story, they got themselves all wrapped up, tied up, and tangled up in Jesus in a way that's kind of different than maybe something that you or me would do. This story today comes from your Beginner's Bible, and it's actually called A Hole in the Roof. Why would it be called A Hole in the Roof? That doesn't sound like a good thing. If there's a hole in my roof, what happens? And it rains, I get wet. But maybe there's a good reason for it. Let's see what it says. A hole in the roof. Jesus was at a house preaching. Many people gathered there, and it was because they heard that Jesus was healing the sick people. Look at all these people. They're gathering because they heard Jesus is healing sick people. The house was overflowing with people. Many had to stand even outside. There was no room left, not even outside the door. Look, all those people, they're just standing outside the house just to be close to Jesus. They seem interested in what he has to say. And he's healing sick people. Down the road lived a man who he could not walk. He was paralyzed. That means that his legs didn't work. He couldn't move his legs like you and me can. His friends believed that Jesus could heal him. See the man in his bed? His friends, they have heard what Jesus is doing. So they carried him to the house. But there was still so many people there that they couldn't get inside. So what did they do? Look, they carried him up onto the roof. What are they going to do on the roof? Well, the man's friends, they made a hole in the roof and they lowered the man down to Jesus. Look, see, they're lowering him down to Jesus through a hole in the roof. Jesus saw, he saw that the men helping this man on the mat there, he saw that they had faith. He knew how much that they loved their friend. Jesus said to the man, "Your sins are forgiven." I bet that's not what they expected him to say. But he also said, "Stand up, pick up your bed, and walk. Go home." And you know what? The man stood up and he walked in the sight of everybody. And the whole crowd praised God. Wow. That is amazing. I've seen people that had to ride in wheelchairs. You probably have too. I've seen people, in fact, a friend of mine just last year was in an accident and she hurt her neck and now her arms and legs don't work right anymore. And things like that happen sometimes where something happens to us and our body doesn't work right anymore. I've seen people that that's happened to, and I'm so thankful that I can use my arms and I can use my legs too, right? And I bet you are also thankful for that. But these people, their friend, he couldn't use his legs. He couldn't walk. So what did they do? Well, if you think about it, they were wrapped up and tied up and tangled up in belief that Jesus could help their friend. They knew. They said, he's healing people. Let's take him to Jesus because Jesus can help. And he did. He said, get up, pick up your mat and walk. And he sure did. But what else did he say? This part, I think, is even more important. He said, your sins are forgiven. Now, for you and me, that's kind of maybe confusing to understand, but that is the most important part because Jesus came to this world for you and for me, for all of everybody that is a human person. Everybody, no matter where you're from, no matter what you look like, he came for you to forgive our sins. Because all of us, sometimes we do things that are wrong. And without forgiveness, we couldn't go to heaven. So Jesus came, and just like in this story, he said, your sins are forgiven. He can say that to you and to me. Maybe we don't have legs and arms that don't work, but we do have sin, and he can forgive it. And that is a good thing. So I don't know about you, but I want to be wrapped up, tied up, and tangled up in Jesus, because I know that with him, I can be forgiven. So why don't we stand up one more time and let's sing our song together.
Wrapped up, tied up, tangled up. Got it? I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in Jesus. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in God. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in Jesus. I'm all wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in God. Oh yeah. Let's try it a little faster. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in Jesus. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in God. I'm all wrapped up, I'm all tied up, I'm all tangled up in Jesus. I'm all wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in God. Oh yeah. I always like singing that song. Okay.
Okay. Why don't we pray, and then we'll be done with Bible class today. God, we thank you so very much for Jesus, because Jesus came to this world and he was able to forgive sins, but he did this miraculous healing. He healed somebody of their brokenness, their paralyzed legs. And then he said, so that you know that I can forgive sins. And so we know that he forgives our sins. And so we ask that every day you would help us to follow you, to love you, to know you, to be wrapped up in you. Now, we're thankful for Jesus, and I'm thankful for each of these people that are listening. I pray that you would watch over them and bless them and keep them. Thank you so much for Jesus and forgiveness in his name. And we pray all of these things in his name. Amen. All right. Thank you for coming to Bible class today. I hope that I will see you again next week. Take care.